And as Shadia said, in Wales, the results are coming in with 13 constituencies declared. Labour are on 8, losing the Vale of Clwyd to the Tories. There are 60 seats up for grabs in the Welsh Parliament, the Senedd. That means the Labour Party will need a majority of 31 to control the Welsh Government, something no party has ever been able to achieve. Back in 2016, Labour won 29 seats and were forced to form a coalition with opposition parties, while the Tories won 11 seats. Well, joining me now from Cardiff is journalist and political commentator Marcus Stead. Marcus, Labour have never secured a majority in the Welsh Assembly and they've been having a bad day in other parts of the UK, haven't they?
Good evening, Kate. Yes, the one thing to bear in mind at the very start of this is that it seems as though the Welsh electorate are making a clear divide between Sir Keir Starmer and the UK Labour Party and Mark Drakeford and the Welsh Labour Party. And I think what the last 18 months or so has done is it's given a greater awareness among the Welsh population as to where power now lies, because we've had, 22 years since the Assembly, as it was then known, came into being. Turnout at elections has never been above 47%. There was a sort of disconnect and a disinterest. It may well be, actually, looking at these early results, that turnout still hasn't gone up much beyond that. But what has changed, Kate, is that there is now a much greater awareness of the fact that it's Cardiff Bay and Mark Drakeford's government that decides things like the NHS and education, and not Westminster. So in many ways, Kate, this feels like a bit of a mini referendum on Mark Drakeford's handling of the pandemic.
Indeed. Well, the parliamentary results have only just started to come in, but coalition talks with Plaid Cymru are likely to take place, aren't they?
Well, we're in a bit of a strange situation here, Kate, because, as you rightly just said a moment ago, no party has ever got above 30, i.e. half the seats in the chamber. But as things stand, what we do know so far is that Labour is going to be the largest party. I can't see any way that that's not going to happen. The Conservatives, it's now almost certain they're going to finish in second place, with Plaid Cymru in third. And the basic arithmetic of it is that Labour could only do a coalition agreement with Plaid Cymru. There's no realistic prospect of any kind of coalition with the Conservatives. However, Kate, there's a problem here. In that Adam Price, the Plaid Cymru leader, one of his big ticket selling points when he became leader in September 2018 was no repeat of the arrangement from 2007 to 2011. For that 4-year period, Plaid Cymru were the junior partners in a Labour-led coalition, and Adam Price made it abundantly clear there would be no repeat of that. And he repeated in an interview just last September, he said it would have to be a partnership of equals this time around. Well, it looks as though Plaid Cymru are going to get either just below or just above a quarter of the seats. They would have no mandate for a partnership of equals with that number of seats.
So we have a stalemate, won't we? Labour will want to keep the union intact, and Plaid will obviously want pressure for a Welsh independence vote.
Well, this is what makes the next few hours so fascinating, Kate. We're only about halfway through the constituency votes. We've got 40 constituencies. The remaining 20 seats are done via a very complicated list system. We're only halfway through. There's lots of knife-edge seats that are going to be declared over the course of this evening. It's been a very long afternoon. Results trickled through as the afternoon went on. They've really livened up in the last three quarters of an hour or so. A lot will depend on how close to that 30 figure Labour get. If they're on 27 or 28, they may well fancy going it alone, as they did last time with the support of the sole Liberal Democrat and one independent member, the former Plaid Cymru leader, David Ellis-Thomas, who had left the party by that stage. But if it's like 23, 24, 25, then we really are in a potential stalemate situation. It's hard to see a way through without Adam Price backtracking on what he said before. It's just very complicated. So the next few hours, there's a huge amount up for grabs, Kate.
Indeed. Well, some have argued that Welsh devolution should be scrapped altogether, but surely then it's not going to go away anytime soon, is it?
Well, it does seem there is. We've got the Abolish the Welsh Assembly Party, and UKIP have also stood on a platform of abolishing the institution. That is a minority viewpoint, but there was one opinion poll just a few months ago that showed that support for abolishing the Assembly, or the Welsh Parliament as it's now known, was higher than that of Welsh independence. But different opinion polls are telling us different things. But it does appear, Kate, that the majority viewpoint at this moment in time in Wales is for the continuation of devolution, with or without increased powers. There's some dispute over that. But broadly speaking, there is support for the status quo within the broader United Kingdom framework.
Indeed. Parliament, not Assembly, you're right. You're taking me back to my student days. Marcus Stead, thank you very much indeed.
Thank you.